Using a duck to create awareness about the rise in sea levels. That's what a new multi-partner statewide campaign aims to do. Joining us now with the details are Rachel Beasley with the State Department of Land and Natural Resources and Kathleen Pahinui with the Board of Water Supply. Good morning to you both. Thanks for joining us today.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Tell us more about this campaign. What's going on?
Sure. Yeah, thank you. So this is, we're kicking it off today, November 9th. This is being launched by the Hawaii Climate Change Committee. The Hawaii Climate Change Mitigation and Adaptation Commission, along with the Honolulu Board of Water Supply. As you had mentioned, this is a multi-partner statewide effort to inform our local communities here about the impacts of sea level rise. And it's really unique, as you'd mentioned, because it has a duck, and it's not just any duck. This is a koloa, which is a Hawaiian duck. And it's not just any koloa, it's a koloa iki.
Talk more about sea level rise for us and why it's so important, not just to those who live right by the ocean along the shoreline, but for everybody.
Sure. So Koloa Iki, I'd like to give credit to the very talented local artist, Solomon Enos. So Koloa Iki lives and depends on the wetlands. And so she's very intimately knowledgeable about and affected by sea level rise. And sea level rise, when we think about it, we think about the shoreline mostly, potentially, but it's actually also inland areas as well. And so as we see this sea level rise, we're going to see erosion of the coastline, but we're also going to be seeing flooding inland in low-lying inland areas, even on a sunny day. And so this is something that, you know, is going to affect everyone. And Koloa Iki, being a keiki, really wants to inform people in a very amusing and exciting way. KoloaIki.org is where you can go and find activities. There's a wonderful song on there that was composed by Suzanne and Michael McCrary. We also, Koloa Iki also invites everyone to come sing along with the song and upload their videos. Also on the website, there are other resources too. So it's not just for keiki, although adults as well love to do coloring pages, which are right behind me here, and other quizzes. But we have other resources as well. So this right here is the Hawaii Sea Level Rise Vulnerability and Adaptation Report. This is a very crucial report. It's a framework for providing a framework for assessing climate change. And it provides recommendations to reduce our exposure and increase our capacity to adapt to sea level rise. Now, in association with that report, we also have a viewer. This is an interactive map, and it's throughout our state. And you can click on any area, and it will show you from 1 foot of sea level rise to 3.2 feet of sea level rise, where are you going to see this flooding? As I mentioned, flooding is not just along the coastlines, but you'll also be seeing flooding inland as well.
And Kathleen, what's your message, your final message to residents living here about why this is all important and how they should get involved?
Well, the reason the Board of Water Supply is so interested in this topic is a lot of our infrastructure, as you know, are in the streets and along the coastal highways. But as Rachel pointed out, even in areas like Nimitz and Alawai, and we were fixing a pipe even in Kailua a couple weeks ago, and we have to dewater the trenches. So it makes fixing main breaks a little bit more challenging, which of course then adds to the costs. And so one of our goals is to work with the experts on this issue to develop in ways to deal with it, manage it, and in some cases, move our infrastructure.
All right, thank you to you both, Kathleen and Rachel, for joining us this morning. Have a great day.
Thanks, Christine, really appreciate it. Mahalo,
bye.